Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' physics.
Ladies and gentle people, the bell has rung, therefore class has begun, therefore you should be seated in your seat, ready and excited to do a graphical, uniformly accelerated motion problem.
Uniformly.
I thought it was uniformally.
Nope.
It's uniformly.
Thanks. I'm glad to see we can all say uniformly correctly now. Today we have a problem. The problem specifically states, assuming an initial position of zero, complete the empty graphs you may assume to sig figs. So we have a velocity as a function of time graph. You could see we have 1, 2, and 3 seconds on all of our time graphs. You could see we have the blue line represents the motion, and we have 2, 4, and 6 meters per second for our velocities. And we have two empty graphs, a position and an acceleration graph. And our goal is to fill in those graphs. Now, we've done this in a broad sense without numbers, but today we're going to have numbers. Bobby, before we begin, could you please tell me how do we know from looking at the graph that this is uniformly accelerated motion?
The slope of the line is a constant number, and the slope of a velocity versus time graph is acceleration, and therefore the acceleration is constant.
Great! Constant slope on a velocity versus time graph means we have a constant acceleration. And how are we going to find that acceleration?
We use the equation definition of acceleration. Acceleration equals change in velocity over change in time.
Actually, we should use the UAM equation. Velocity final equals velocity initial plus acceleration times change in time.
No, we should clearly use the definition.
We should use the UAM equation.
Definition.
UAM equation.
You are so wrong.
Me?
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, you are wrong.
UAM equation.
I don't think so.
Are you both delirious and daft? They're the same thing.
No way.
What?
Not possible.
Actually, Bobby, you are correct. If you start with the equation for acceleration, acceleration equals the change in velocity over change in time. Change in is always final minus initial, so we have velocity final minus velocity initial. Then if you multiply both sides by the change in time, you get the acceleration times the change in time is equal to velocity final minus the velocity initial. You can then add the velocity initial to both sides and switch sides here. You get velocity final equals the velocity initial plus the acceleration times the change in time. In other words, these two equations are equivalent. Bobby, you're right.
Well, I'll be.
Okay, I'm down with that. Very nice, Bobby.
Acceleration equals change in velocity over change in time. Delta change in is always final minus initial. So we get velocity final minus velocity initial on top divided by the quantity time final minus time initial on the bottom. Billy, can you please figure out the numbers for me?
Well, we need to pick 2 points on the graph, and because the slope is constant, it doesn't really matter which 2 points we pick. We will get the same answer. So let's go from 0 to 3 seconds. Velocity final is then 6 meters per second, and velocity initial is zero. Time final is 3 seconds, and time initial is zero. That gives us 2.0 meters per second squared for our acceleration.
And how do we draw a constant acceleration of 2.0 meters per second squared on our acceleration versus time graph? Bo?
Because the acceleration doesn't change, you draw a horizontal line at the acceleration value of 2.0 meters per second squared.
Great, now all we need is the position as a function of time graph. We already have the initial position from the problem statement. The initial position is zero. Bobby, what will the general shape of the position versus time graph be?
Honestly, I have no idea where to start.
Remember that the slope of a position versus time graph is velocity.
And on the graph, the initial velocity is zero and increases from there.
Okay, thanks. So the slope of the position versus time graph needs to start out at zero and then increase over time. So it's an upward sloping curve. You're going to need your magic tangent line finder to show us that.
Got it. Magic tangent line finder. So yeah, it's going to be an upward sloping curve, generally something like this. So you can see the initial slope of the tangent line needs to be equal to zero because the initial velocity is equal to zero. And as time goes by, the slope of the position as a function of time graph needs to increase because the velocity increases. Therefore, you can see using our magic tangent line finder that the slope of this curve increases as a function of time. Now, this is just an approximation. We actually need to go through now and figure out the numbers.
It's UAM. We can use the UAM equations. Use displacement equals 1/2 times the quantity of velocity final minus velocity initial times the change in time. Oh, and the change in time would then be the time final minus the time initial.
Absolutely. All we need now is the numbers. I'll go through and do this one. So I chose three different displacements to solve for, the displacement from 0 to 1 seconds, the displacement from 0 to 2 seconds, and from 0 to 3 seconds. I'll walk through the first one. The displacement from 0 to 1 seconds is going to be 1/2 times the velocity at 1 second plus the velocity at 0 seconds, multiplied by the time at 1 second minus the time at 0 seconds. The numbers then are going to be 1/2 times the quantity 2 plus 0, then times the quantity 1 minus 0, and we get 1.0 meters. Doing the same thing for the displacement from 0 to 2 seconds, we end up with 4 meters, and the displacement then from 0 to 3 seconds ends up being 9 meters. Bo, I'm now going to erase this graph of position as a function of time because this was just an approximation. Tell me, how are we going to take this information now and draw our position as a function of time graph?
You plot the 3 points and then add the upward sloping curve. At 1 second, the position would be 1 meter. At 2 seconds, the position is 2 meters. And at 3 seconds, the position is 9 meters. Then you just draw on the upward sloping curve.
Very nice, everybody. That completes the problem. You probably noticed one of the other things that I do not excel at is drawing curves. Oh well. Any questions on the problem we just went through?
It all makes sense to me.
Great. Let's just go through and do a quick review then. We started out by showing that because the slope of the velocity as a function of time graph was constant, we had a constant acceleration, therefore we could use the UAM equations. Then we showed that the equation for acceleration, which is equal to change in velocity over change in time, is actually equivalent to one of the UAM equations, velocity final equals velocity initial plus acceleration times the change in time. We then figured out our acceleration, again, because it's constant, that means it's going to have a horizontal line on the acceleration as a function of time graph. We then used one of our UAM equations to figure out three different displacements, plotted those on the position as a function of time graph, then I did my best to draw the curve to match those different points. That's what we did. Ladies and gentlemen, people, I hope you enjoyed learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.
Lecture notes are available at flippingphysics.com. Please enjoy lecture notes responsibly.